Kapi, thank you so much for being with us today on Forbes African CV. It's been an amazing day with you.
Thanks for your time,
your energy. I want to go straight into it. So you've had like an interesting trajectory in this industry. Our audience, they want to know, what drives you?
I think for me, it's just every dream, I think, starts with I don't want to say desperation, but I've always wanted to prove myself. I think for me, sort of, you know, growing up with an inspiring dad and also a mother who told me that, I guess, you can be whatever you want to be. It's really always having that ambition. And I almost call it like a fear of failing, a fear of not achieving what you want to achieve. And from a young age, I've always wanted to prove myself in my own right. So I think I've always looked for ways to express myself, but in ways that, I guess, made sense to me. So people always ask me, what are your sort of memories of music? And it's definitely, you know, being sort of like 6 years old in the car, my dad and I would listen to Fela Kuti, and I didn't really understand what music was, but I was moved by it and I appreciated it. So I think sort of having that creative background and also that ambition definitely drove me forward. And being born in Nigeria, being born and bred here in Lagos, but then having that sort of Western culture as well, it really opened my mind to new experiences. And I've always wanted to find a way of expressing myself that sort of reflected my two influential cultures. When I was 16, I bought myself some secondhand decks, and I remember telling my parents I was going to be a DJ. And you know, my parents were like, particularly my dad, he said, well, you know, whatever you want to do, just make sure you're the best at it. So it's definitely that keeps me going every day.
So you have this strong passion for Africa. I mean, you've really, really been very strong on your branding and talking about you're an ambassador. What is it about Africans that really, really speaks to you?
For me, fashion is a big one. I think that it's fantastic that African designers are now getting, I think, the kind of recognition they deserve. Because I think for a very long time, if we look back to Africans expressing themselves, fashion and attire was a very big way. And I think it's not only what we wear as Africans, it's the way we wear what we wear. You know, we have this certain pride. And for me, I think it's great that we're seeing also young designers coming out as well. I think also the actual, you know, business and economics of the way fashion houses work is now being, it's a very lucrative business. So I think that it's great that we're seeing fashion come in. And also another inspiration for me is African literature and art. You know, again, I love art, I appreciate it. Am I a great artist? No. But can I appreciate and draw inspiration? Certainly. So I think that, you know, I think that in all, Africans are now, you know, focusing on, you know, telling their stories their way, and also essentially, you know, letting people have an insight into what Africa is. And I love to debate this whole sort of, you know, Africa as one, because Africa is such a rich continent, full of so many different perspectives on the continent itself.
So Kapi, what is your message to young aspiring African women?
That's such a great question. You know, I would love to see African women as fearless and also as unique. I think that it's so interesting, Abby. We're seeing a lot of, obviously with a lot of infrastructure coming up in the continent, a lot more exposure, a lot more, I guess, you know, synergy between the Western world and here. People are suddenly saying, oh yeah, oh, Africa is getting better. But it's a relative thing, really. And that's on the assumption that Africa is becoming better because there's more synergy between the Western world. I think that Africa should not lose its uniqueness. And again, you know, with me, for example, with my DJing, you know, even though I'm doing something that is more, I guess, more accepted or more understood in the Western world with female DJing, I'm still also constantly trying to find ways to make it more unique to home. You know, I'm excited. I'm going to start having drummers in my sets, my live sets, you know, or making things more unique. So it's almost like it's like me trying to brand myself as, you know, as a US or UK DJ. You know, but it's also trying to be an African in my own right, an Africa that is taking what is theirs, but not changing what they are.
Absolutely, that's fantastic. It's a refreshing view, and I think a lot of young aspiring African women hopefully will resonate with them as
yes,
well. So well, thank you so much, Kapi, for your time. It's been an absolute pleasure chatting with you.
Thank you.
And we look forward to everyone sharing this with us.
Thank you so much, and thank you for having me.
Thank you.